In this video, you'll learn over 20 insane ways to abuse Shadowmeld in Season 3. Whether it's countering entire boss mechanics or skipping some of the most frustrating packs, Shadowmeld is broken, and today you will see why. Some of these tricks come directly from our Dungeons courses at skillcap.com. So if you're the type of player who loves advanced dungeon mechanics, or if you want to min-max your damage and healing with class-specific tips, then SkillCap is the perfect place for you. For a limited time, we're even offering one free VOD review per month for signing up, which is a value of up to $500 and can help you hit your rating goals alongside our courses. We're so confident that our service works that we even offer a rank-up guarantee. If you think you're in a slump, just use our guides risk-free and we promise you will gain IO. So, what are you waiting for? Visit the links below for an exclusive discount offer. For now, let's get back to the video. We're going to start with some bangers first, showing you the dungeons where Shadowmeld can have a huge impact. First up, we have Waycrest Manor, where there are three high-value melds. The first is the Etch Channel from the Rune Weaver mobs. This ability ticks incredibly hard every second and does massive damage in higher keys. In most cases, this requires some damage reduction to survive, but if you simply press Shadowmeld mid-channel, it will stop the cast immediately, allowing you to save your defensives for something else. Then, on the third boss of the dungeon, you actually can Shadowmeld Rotten Expulsion, and doing so will actually put the spell on CD. This isn't exactly game-breaking, but since this mechanic spawns some annoying puddles, using Shadowmeld here makes the fight much cleaner. Finally, on Lord and Lady Waycrest, you can completely counter Virulent Pathogen with the Night Elf Racial. If you're targeted by this ability from Lord Waycrest, simply press Meld mid-cast, and by doing so, you can instantly avoid this disease and put the ability on CD, while also saving someone in your group from burning Global to Dispel. Moving on to Atal'Dazar, we have a few more high-value melds. The first is on Resin, and this one is very unique. Most of you probably know by now that Pursuit can be cancelled by any target dropping effect, which includes Shadowmeld, Vanish, Greater Invisibility, and so on. But what many people don't know is that Pursuit can be cancelled by anyone pressing Shadowmeld, regardless if they are the target being chased. Another major ability worth melding is the Soulburn ability from the Colossus mobs on the south side of the dungeon. This channeled spell hits incredibly hard, but a quick meld will instantly cancel it and put the ability on CD. The next two melds are very situational, but can be useful if you are low on HP. The first is Deadeye Aim from Dinomancer Kisho in the center of the dungeon. You can cancel this cast with meld, but it will be immediately recast again, either on you or someone else, so this is only recommended if you are low and need to avoid getting hit. The same principle applies to Yasma's Racking Pain. While you can technically stop the cast with a meld, it will be immediately recast anyway, so once again, this is only useful if you are low and worried about dying. Galakrond's Fall is another dungeon with some boss-breaking meld tech. During the Blight of the Galakrond encounter, the boss will randomly cast Corrosive Infusion on a targeted player, which applies a nasty ticking dot that needs to first be transferred to the tank and then cleared by soaking the frontal called Blight Reclamation. But if the targeted player melds in the middle of the cast, then the mechanic will deal 0 damage and will actually go on cooldown. This is especially valuable on phase 2 and 3 because of overlapping AoE damage. So if you want to help your healer out, be sure to meld quickly if you are targeted by Corrosive Infusion. The last boss in Fall also has some useful Shadowmeld tech. If you're targeted by Extinction Blast, then be sure to Shadowmeld mid-cast since it will prevent the initial hit from happening. This is a massive help for your healer since immediately after, Iridicron will start channeling Stonecrack Barrage, allowing you to avoid some overlapping damage. Throughout the dungeon, there are some low-impact moments to Shadowmeld. One is against the Time Stream Leeches, who cast Enervate, which can normally be kicked, but in case this cast goes through, the mob will no longer be interruptible, but you can still meld or simply CC any follow-up casts if needed. Now let's move on to Black Rook Hold, with two major Shadowmeld spots. The first one you might not know about. After the last boss phases and becomes a Dreadlord, they will cast Shadow Bolt Volley, which at this stage of the fight can be pretty brutal since you don't have the Legacy of the Ravencrest buff. You can delay the volley by using meld twice. If your tank melds the first cast and you're able to taunt meld the second like Stove does here, then you can actually delay long enough to get the Legacy buff. Of course, this is very difficult to coordinate in pugs, but is an amazing way to counter this mechanic without using defensives. The remaining two Shadow Melds in the dungeon are quite situational. The second boss will target a player with Brutal Glaive, which leaves a nasty bleed and can be cast back-to-back on the same player. Shadow Melding won't reset the CD, but can be useful to press if you already have the bleed to force the mechanic on someone else, which is good to do as a cloth wearer since the damage is physical. You can also do the same against Risen Archers. On higher keys, their shoot can pack a punch, and if you're already low, then Shadow Melding here can be helpful, but keep in mind it will automatically be recast. Darkheart Thicket has a few different Shadowmeld tricks, with the last boss having two high-value melds. Shade of Xavius will cast Nightmare Bolt and will channel Feed on the Weak, and Meld will put each respective ability on CD. Between these two, Feed on the Weak is more important to Meld since it deals more damage, and you will want to press it quickly since it is a channeled ability. Darkheart Thicket also has a fairly useful skip you can do with Shadowmeld. There's a pack on the south side of the dungeon with two keepers and two flowers, which can be an absolute pain and offer crumbs for count. If you have a demon hunter in the group, they can use their fear sigil to CC this pack, allowing the group to run by, followed by the demon hunter pressing meld to drop combat and reset the pack. Moving on to Everbloom, there is one pretty useful meld that many players don't know about. Near the third boss are three different mage mobs, pyromancers, ice callers, and arcanomancers, all with three main spells. Now, typically you will just cycle interrupts on these casts since these mobs are immune to CC. But if a kick isn't ready, then you can actually shadow meld their cast, which puts the spell on cooldown. On the Ancient Protector's boss, tanks can use shadow meld to avoid the noxious charge casts from Dullhoo. In order for this to work, you can shadow meld late into the cast, which prevents the damage entirely and denies the puddles from spawning. If your tank isn't a night elf, someone else in your group who is can taunt and then meld to prevent the cast. This is obviously a bit trickier, and you need to make sure your tank immediately taunts back. You can also use shadow meld on the Ancient Protector's boss to avoid their bolt casts, but this is less useful since the spell will immediately target someone else. Once again, this will only come in handy if you are critically low on HP and need to bounce the attack to someone else. Throne of Tides has some fairly useful meld tech, and this first one you might have overlooked. As you know, the first boss will phase at 60% and 30%, but here's the thing. She also has a targeted cast called Shock Blast, which might seem rather useless to meld since it doesn't go on CD, but if you meld the cast while she is right above 60 or 30%, then she will actually stop her recast and automatically go into the intermission, acting almost like a kick on the boss herself. Outside of this, everything is pretty minor. One cast that can be useful to Shadow Meld is Crushing Depths from the Sentinels in order to bypass the Healing Absorb. You can also meld Mind Flay from the Faceless Seer to stop the channel. Once again, not that useful unless you need to be ultra safe. Finally, Murozond's Rise doesn't have much when it comes to high impact melds, but there is a niche situation on the last boss where it can come in handy. During the first phase, infinite keepers will spawn and will cast Chronal Burn, which cannot be interrupted and leaves a nasty dispellable dot. You can meld this and put it on cooldown, but the spell has a short CD anyway, but this is mostly useful when there are two keepers up, since your healer will only be able to dispel one debuff, otherwise you could simply dwarf the dot off. Beyond this, there really isn't too much. You can meld the infinite burn from the Rift Mages if there's no kick ready. Shadow Meld is also good as a standalone racial no matter what dungeon you're in. By now, it should be clear that dropping targets while casting is arguably the most practical, and many spells can get pseudo-interrupted like this, but only some of them will actually go on cooldown. Shadow Meld is also a great aggro drop, especially if you're one of those specs that does huge burst damage like Demon Hunter or Fury Warrior. If you're a rogue or druid, Shadow Meld is a pseudo-vanish, and can give you the ability to re-stealth. Particularly useful for rogues since it can give you access to stealth abilities and all their benefits like subterfuge, underhanded upper hand, and more. As a druid, you can also use Shadow Meld for an emergency rake stun if needed, like Roybin showcases here. Any healer that can be night elf can benefit from the combat drop too, since it allows you to sneak in some drinks. Note that this doesn't work against any boss, however. On paper, you could also sneak in a res as a healer with Shadow Meld, but this can be hard to do since it means ignoring your group for a few seconds. And finally, as we showcased, Meld is a great option for skipping some of the most obnoxious and inefficient trash packs. So there you have it, over 20 incredible ways to use Shadow Meld in Season 3. But hey, maybe some of you know some more. Drop a comment below if you have any Shadow Meld secrets to share. And while you're doing that, we want to remind you of our risk-free rank-up guarantee at skillcap.com. We have the largest collection of Mythic Plus guides on the internet curated into class and dungeon courses that are designed with a simple goal of delivering you great results. And if you want personalized help from an expert player, we're offering one free VOD review every month just for signing up. This is a rare opportunity to get direct feedback from cutting-edge players that you see compete every year in the MDI and TGP. So what are you waiting for? Visit the links below to get started with an exclusive discount offer. Alright guys, that wraps it up for this one. As always, we want to thank you all for watching. See you soon.